you are unstoppable. Amitabh Shahji and his whole team present here today. The enablers of, if I may say, a new and resurgent India, seated around our table. And those who are joining us virtually at this point of time. It is indeed an honor and a pleasure to be amongst all of you. I must say that I am overwhelmed. I'm very thankful for the contribution and the coming together of what has become in very, very early days a mission for Amitabh and his team, which has transcended into reality. As I heard all of you across the table this afternoon, and I heard of many, many stories, many, many missions, many, many goals. And then the founders of this initiative that have coalesced, if you will, this energy together. And then we saw two wonderful results of this initiative in my young friends present here this afternoon. In many ways, this is very symbolic of what a successful enterprise must be. Across the world, if you look at countries that have succeeded, if you look at geographies that have succeeded, if you look at populations that have succeeded, they have been very firmly implanted on two fundamentals. And those fundamentals have historically always been education and health. Hamare desh mein kaha jata hai, ki teen daata hai. Pehla daata hai jaana daata. सरस्वती की ज्ञान जो हमें व्यापक रूप से निर्धारित करते हमारे गुरु हमारे शिक्षक, दूसरा है हमारा जानदार हमारा चिकित्सक जो हमें स्वस्थ रखता है, जो जीवन यापन के लिए हमें क्षमता देता है, और तीसरा दाता है हमारा अन्नदाता, किसान जो फसल हुआ इसके आधार पर जो किसान देश नहीं लेकिन आज जो देश का किसान विश्व का पेट है, ज्ञानदाता ज्ञानदाता और अन्नदाता। और किसी भी सफल देश के रहस्य के पीछे तीन दाताओं का बहुत महत्वपूर्ण योगदान है। मेरा भी थोड़ा सा बैकग्राउंड, जनसेवा में आने के पहले एक प्रोफेशनल बैकग्राउंड है। आई यूज्ड टू बी अ बैंकर ऑन दैट स्ट्रीट मेंशन, एंड आई एम ग्लैड prior to Amitabh, I moved off that street. So I had a wonderful experience on that street. Learned a lot. And I believe that every experience of journey in life, you must always carry all kinds of experiences. It's as important for you to understand and know what is it that you don't like. As important as it is for you to know what is it that you are passionate about, what is it that you like. Because in that journey of life, you never know when fate falls upon you. to use that arrow in your quiver, which has been marked away in your hard drive many, many years ago. Life is an accumulation of experiences. And therefore, every experience in life, I believe, is for me and my family, education has been a passion way before we entered conversation. My family, the last 100-150 years, has been very focused on education since 5 or 6 generations. Because we did believe that ensuring that a successful foundation is extremely important to empowering people. And I do believe that in India today, as in every other country, the focus that the Prime Minister has put both on health and education, and one of our members who spoke about it on vocational training, all three are very, very important pillars in the success of any country. Education in India today has undergone a metamorphosis change. A country that has always been proud of her legacy in the area of education, all the days, way back from the Indus Valley Civilization. Around that period when Aryabhatta invented his theory, students, sense of mathematics to then the Nalanda model of education. So India has always been a country that has A, propounded education, B, one that has always been at the cusp of education. And I believe that everything in life goes through a chakra, very much like the shoe. I think the education and the pedagogical system in India has also gone through that journey. And what started in terms of a, if you will, a phoenix from India, in terms of being the fountainhead of learning, that circle has come fully around to today, India once again becoming the fountainhead of learning. Through our avatars today of Indus Valley Civilization and other than IITs and IIMs and educational institutions. And I believe that the impact that these institutions have in all our lives in very different ways is extremely important. So India has transformed from a model that was based on gurukuls to today, Amitabh's model of digital classrooms, from a model that was based on learning in an environment of forests, today virtual classes. From rote-based learning to now the new NEP, experiential-based learning. And I think we've traversed a long journey, especially in our journey from independence to Amritkal. The last 9 years when the whole education sector has completely transformed. One of the biggest problems and challenges in India today has been not the spawning of institutions, but the spawning of quality institutions. The very fact that today in India, every year we are setting up a new university, every week we are setting up 2 new colleges, providing those avenues of learning to our students. So I think that Amitabh's enterprise, the very fact that he is a shining example of the opportunity that India presents to the world, not only in terms of business, not only in terms of building new companies or unicorns, but also in the area of social enterprise. The very fact that we today in India are experiencing a process of a brain gain rather than a brain drain. We have young people such as Amitabh coming back to Yale and setting up institutions such as this with a cause that is very close to his heart. I must congratulate him. It's been a very difficult journey, I would believe, stayed the course, and very much like the child that he talked about, in his corner, facing the wall and concentrating on his book. जैसे पुराने जमाने में अर्जुन की तीर मछली की आंख पे थी, वैसे हमारे अमिताभ की तीर भी सामाजिक न्याय और सामाजिक विकास की आंख पे थी. And so therefore I feel very privileged. Must congratulate him and his full team for the 18 years that they have covered this park. The fact that they have been able to get people such as yourselves passionately tied to this mission. There is a difference between being tied to a cause and having passion in that engagement. And I see very much of that in all of you. I do believe that what we have started today in these 65 schools that have impacted almost about 6,500 students across Madhya Pradesh and many, many lakhs of students that we have impacted across India. And one of the things that has impacted me the most, and it's a very intangible thing, but I think it affects our productivity in a huge manner, is look at the environment that he has created in those schools. Look at the environment that he has created in those Andhra Pradesh. वातावरण से बहुत परिवर्तन आ गया. छोटी चीजें मैं आपको बता दूं कि जिस वातावरण में अगर सूर्य की रोशनी हो और सूर्य का प्रकाश हो और ये आर्टिफिशियल लाइट हो, वहां प्रोडक्टिविटी 10 गुना ज्यादा बढ़ जाती है. और बच्चों के लिए रोमांचक वातावरण जो तैनात किया इन्होंने, जो स्कूल्स का वातावरण तैनात किया है, जो आंगनबाड़ी का वातावरण तैनात किया है, NID से डिजाइन उन्होंने करवाया, मुझे तो ऐसा लग रहा था कि मुझे जाके स्कूल में पढ़ने की इच्छा जाए. मैं मजाक नहीं करूँ. स्वच्छ वातावरण, नीट वातावरण, स्वच्छ भारत की कल्पना प्रधानमंत्री जी कर रहे हैं, वो स्वच्छ भारत की कल्पना इन संस्थाओं में. इट्स ऑल अबाउट द एनवायरनमेंट, इट्स ऑल अबाउट providing that area of engagement. And I think that's been done really beautifully. The exterior of those Anganwadis, the interior of those schools. And I think it increases the capability of not only the students to be able to imbibe learning, but also it increases the productivity of teachers. And I think many things that we forget about in our journey, while we look at this social imperative, as important as it is to create an environment for students, it's as important to create that environment for teachers as well. Constant learning on the job for every person, be it a student, be it a teacher, is paramount. And therefore, one of the other things that we need to look at in our country as well is also teacher student. And why do I say that? If you look at successful enterprises across the world, be that in areas of banking or consulting, or look at companies that have been successful across the world, the ones that have been successful are not the ones that hand out the biggest paycheck. The ones who are successful are only those institutions that constantly provide a source of learning. And if you are engaged in your organization, if you find that your learning curve is always very steep, you will always be eager to get back to work the next day. And that's the environment that we need to provide, on the one hand for our students, but also for our teachers. And so therefore I must commend आजादी के अमृतकाल के वातावरण में शिक्षा के क्षेत्र में, आंगनवाड़ी के क्षेत्र में जो सफर युवा अनस्टॉपेबल कर रहा है 18 वर्ष, एंड टू बी एबल टू इग्नाइट दिस यूथ इज द मोस्ट फंडामेंटल अपॉर्चुनिटी फॉर अस. वी टुडे हैव प्रॉब्ली द लार्जेस्ट यूथ बल्ज इन द वर्ल्ड. 70% ऑफ इंडिया इज बिलो द एज ऑफ 25. Not merely a statistic, we're talking about 91 crore people. three times the population of the United States of America, two times the population of Europe. That's a huge opportunity for India. How do you ignite that opportunity? Right? And I think that's the focus that we need to have. And so on, where on the one hand, I must congratulate Amitabh for what he has achieved, I want to also congratulate him and his institution for one other thing. I've always found through my 20-odd years in public service that there is a need. And there are organizations such as yourselves who want to fulfill that need. But between the need and organizations such as yourselves that want to fulfill that need, there has to be a gap analysis. That gap analysis is vehicles that will actually be able to bridge that. So I think the biggest service that you are Unstoppable is doing is in its effort to be able to be that vehicle that bridges the gap between the need and the desire of organizations such as yourselves to be the vehicles to fulfill that. So on both counts, I'd like to congratulate Amitabh and his team. And as far as education is concerned, Benjamin Franklin once said that investment in education yields the best interest ever possible. See, I think that's the key takeaway for us as a society, as an organization, and as a country. So Amitabh, to you and your team, first of all, congratulations. All of you, thank you for coming on board and helping initiatives like this. We need more of that to happen. And finally, thank you very much for having me.